Hey guys, what's up? I hope you guys are having a wonderful day so far. Today I'm just gonna go through some of your comments that you left on my unboxing video of my AX2000, my new camera, and I'll hopefully answer some of your questions too. So let's begin. Chris Commission Music asked, what were you shooting with? Now I'm assuming that you meant the actual unboxing video itself, and I shot that video on my Sony SR12. So it looks like it is a prosumer quality camera. It has the ability of a mic input, which is kind of nice. It's got a very large LCD screen. It shoots all on a AVC HD format, which you might need a kind of strong computer to handle, but if you guys got a strong enough computer, it's a really nice camera. It shoots in full 1080 HD. It's just fantastic. You know, it can store up to like 400 minutes of video, and just great camera overall. You can get it at Best Buy probably still. I'm pretty sure Sony released a new model of this camera, but I don't know of any specifics, so. The Rondo Show asked, could you please put in the description of everything that you got? I'm very interested in purchasing a few of those items myself, such as the shoulder mount. Well, instead of putting it all in the description, I'm just going to talk about it right here. So the very first thing I got was the Petrol PCCB Compact Camcorder Bag, which cost $94.95, because I know a lot of you guys are asking the prices of these things. Then I also got two 32GB SanDisk Extreme SDHC Class 10 cards. That came to a total price of $425. Then of course I also got the Sony HDR AX2000 Handycam. That was a total price of $3,500. Then I also got the Audio Technicia AT897 shotgun mic kit, which came with a shock mount as well as a little XLR cable to plug the microphone into the camcorder itself. And that was $259.89. And just to give you guys an example of the difference between the internal microphone and the normal microphone, this is what it sounds like with the external microphone. And this is what it sounds like with the internal microphone. So external microphone, internal microphone. Sounds pretty bad, doesn't it? Alright, then I also got the Mighty Wondercam by Videosmith, which is a classic shoulder pod. And that was $214.99. Then I also got the VariZoom aluminum video tripod with a 75mm fluid head, and that was $169.95. Then lastly, I got a Bella Pro Keyboard 3.0 for Final Cut Pro, and that was $124.95. And that keyboard will also work for, I think, Vegas along with Final Cut Express. So if you guys have either of those programs, this keyboard is great. It has a bunch of shortcuts printed on the keys along with a programmable software for shortcuts, which is nice. If you guys want to learn more about those products, I'll put the links down below in the subbar to bnhphoto.com, along with a list of everything that I bought in some text format that you guys can learn. Alright, Virus Everywhere asked, does it actually use SD? Normally Sony uses Pro 2 Duo. Yes, this is true. Sony usually does use Pro 2 Duo. I've got a little 2GB card in this camera right here for capturing photos right now. But I just decided to go with the SDHC cards. That's actually what it was, not the normal SD cards. Mostly just because they're a little bit higher quality than Sony stuff. And I just thought, you know, why not? So I went with those. They're a little bit more expensive, but I think the picture quality is a little bit better. All right, Just For All One asked, what is the name of the background song? All those songs are from Jamendo.com, which is a website where you can get royalty-free music. And the first song that you heard was by a band called Brad Sucks, and the song title was Bad Sign from the album Out of It. And the second song that you guys heard was by a guy named Josh Woodward. The song title was River Went Dry by the album Not Quite Yet. And all of that is under a Creative Commons license, which means you guys are allowed to use those in a YouTube video that you guys make. At the Rondo Show also asked, also one more question, does that camera work perfectly with Final Cut Pro? Yes, it does work with Final Cut Pro. If you just plug it in via a USB cable, it'll show up as like a little hard drive, and you can just, you know, copy over all the video clips that you guys want. Otis and Slayer says, USB cables? You mean FireWire. Actually, no, I do mean USB cables. AVC HD format is what this camera captures in, which was originally invented by Sony and Panasonic. And it just uses USB cables, and it stores it all into a hard drive. It's very not the normal kind of camera type. Normal cameras that don't use AVC HD do capture their stuff over FireWire, simply because it is a little bit nicer quality and whatnot like that. Alright, the Rondo Show asked, is there a reason why you got all this stuff? Yes there is. I like making videos, as you probably can tell. hopefully gonna make some more short films. That's kind of why I got this camera, just because if I were to go to a place and ask if I can film there with this like little kind of camera, they'll probably be like, no, you cannot film here. You're a little kid, you cannot. But with this new big camera, you know, there's more control over a bunch of different features, which is nice. Plus also, if I kind of walk in with that camera, they'll be like, oh, this guy knows what he's doing. Which I suppose it's kind of like a douchebag move, you know, it's all about how you look, but, you know, I guess that's kind of what you gotta do. So I hope I answered all of your questions. If you have any more questions for me, leave these down below. I'm gonna be making some more short films, hopefully. Or I'm gonna be making a short film, hopefully, sometime soon. I'm gonna be collaborating with a friend of mine, and hopefully, her and I will be able to make some good stuff. So on that note, I'll see you guys later, and I hope to see you around soon. Bye!